It is estimated that nearly 10 million Americans are affected by osteoporosis, which causes bones to gradually thin and weaken. One of the medical problems osteoporosis can cause for those over 50, especially senior women, are compression fractures in the vertebrae of the spine. These types of fractures are not only painful, they can also drastically change the way of life for those who suffer from them. Dr. Dana Dunleavy from Winsong Interventional and Vascular Services has seen firsthand how kyphoplasty outpatient procedure and spine jack system has changed the lives of his patients.
Predominantly what we're doing now is really osteoporotic fractures, which just as we get older in general, the bones get weaker, and then we have fractures not from a normal amount of energy or trauma, but from just a small amount. So, you know, you might be bending over to pick up some dust, and that's enough to cause a fracture. And so there's a tremendous opportunity for fracture prevention as well, besides acutely treating these fractures. You know, you can't really plan for a fracture. When it happens, it happens. And so the best thing that we can do is kind of educate the whole community about the fact that when you have a new aspect of severe back pain, it really should be figured out. And people that treat these fractures acutely within the first 7 weeks have better lifetime outcomes than people that wait. As you look at a normal vertebral body, it should look like a building block. You could stack them all up. If you're playing Jenga, you want to make sure that nothing tips over. Now you stick a wedge in here, so this is where the fracture happens. So normally, a vertebral body, because we are upright species, has vertical columns of bone. And as you have a fracture, that becomes disorganized. And so here you can see this is after, and now the fracture is stabilized. Now, we were able to create some height restoration, improving that back to some degree, but because it was 8 months later, you don't get complete height restoration, which we could have achieved if it was done sooner. So it still has a tremendous benefit, but obviously we wish we could have started earlier. Simply, what we do is put a needle in through the bone, and that's obviously done with sedation, plus we're numbing the skin and the bone as well. And when that goes in, it opens up the jack, and then inside the cement flows within that. We call that cement containment, so it's basically going inside the jack that is already there. The nice thing about this is that you're watching it constantly. There's no time where you're blind, essentially. The entire time the cement is going in, it's because I'm putting it in and I'm watching it. And so it's very controlled.
Dr. Margaret Clark, pictured here with her mother Nancy, is a medical professional in the Pittsburgh area. When she found out her mother, who lives in Western New York, was suffering from debilitating back pain, she considered that kyphoplasty could help her condition. That is when she reached out to Dr. Dunleavy and his staff.
My mother actually didn't truly have an injury. She can't think of any particular actual injury. She just developed very, very severe and acute pain in her back and just really couldn't move. And when she got to the hospital, they found that she had an acute compression fracture of her spine. So in other words, she, instead of her, when you look at the side of the spine, instead of it looking like a rectangle, it actually looked more like a pizza wedge. Within 48 hours of the procedure, she had no pain in her back whatsoever. Other than she had a little bit of, there are little tiny incisions involved in the procedure. So other than a little bit of pain associated with the incision, in 48 hours, she was pain-free. She went from sleeping in a recliner to going back to sleeping in her bed. And it has made all the difference in the quality of her life.
It's really rewarding because you can see someone's family member get back to the life they had. And oftentimes by the time a patient gets here with the fracture, really the family has seen their mother, you know, not be able to do the things she did and not act the way she did, because chronic pain is a terrible thing. And so it's really rewarding to see someone a week and 4 weeks and 6 months and 12 months after and see that they've gone back to gardening and gone back to doing activities with their grandkids.